Hi folks, today I have for us two videos to take a look at. One is a news piece from LA, where we get to see a group of frauditors viciously attack an elderly man. And the second video is a pack of frauditors in Philadelphia showing us that they really don't care about transparency, it's all about making themselves feel like the hero. But before we start today's videos, as always, a big thank you to all of my current and new channel members and subscribers. Without your guys' continuous ongoing support, I couldn't keep this channel going. So I thank you all personally from the bottom of my heart. And if you're new to the channel, please subscribe to the page. Leave a like and a comment because it helps me with the algorithm. Don't forget to check out my second channel, NCR Movie Network, the podcast, The Shit Towns, Florida Man Power Ranking. And with all that being said, let's enjoy today's video.
It's a story you saw right here on Fox 11 first. This weird story of a costumed man confronting an elderly woman outside a Brentwood post office. Man jumps to her defense and ends up in a violent brawl. Well, tonight, he's telling his side of the story to Fox 11's Haley Winslow.
A typical quick morning run to the local post office quickly became anything but, with grandma using her cane to whack a couple of stormtroopers over the head and the violence quickly escalating outside.
63-year-old Robert Barrett is back at the Brentwood post office, this time with his arm in a sling, sore neck, and lawyer by his side.
Shoulder dislocated, you know, the guy kicked me in my face, so I got a bruise here, and my eye is swollen.
Head stomped on, held in a chokehold.
This whole struggle.
Now, watching that video does show some very sensitive and very terrible things to see, but how is this defending our First Amendment rights when a pack of frauditors think it's right to harass an elderly woman because she doesn't want to be on their stupid YouTube video? So, she defends herself with the only thing she can, her cane. And when the gentleman came out to see what was going on to try to de-escalate the situation, they insult him, they assault him, and then they jump him. Like the true cowards they are. Now, this was Impact Media and Lizard Media. These two groups have formed a, well, cabal of stupidity and, well, cowards, as we can clearly see in this video.
Was here.
Barrett went in Tuesday just trying to pay his mortgage, met by costumed characters with cameras, he says, riling up customers, including this elderly woman with a cane.
She told him, don't film me, and he's calling her stupid. You're stupid because you don't want to be filmed. They were watching what you were doing, transacting your business with the clerk, virtually cursing you out to get you to say something to them.
They're
Yes.
Group of self-proclaimed First Amendment auditors, known online as Impact Media, and say they stand for freedom of speech.
I'm coming out, and I'm just, you know, and I see the lady having problems with the guy. She's swelling with her stick, and I said, wow, what's going on? And then the guy standing here, I said, well, he's called me something. I said, what did you say? And I turned around, and he pushed me.
Can you believe all this happened at 8:30 in the morning at the post office?
8:30 in the morning at the post office. In Brentwood.
A witness who captures the brawl on camera realizes the severity and calls 911. LAPD officers arrest three of the First Amendment defenders and
hot damn!
Rush Barrett to the hospital.
Free speech doesn't equate to free violence. You know, we may have different views or what have you, but we have to engage in, you know, dialogue and debate as opposed to violence and intimidation.
8 o'clock, Brentwood, come on. Who expects that?
Photographs for news purposes may be taken essentially inside. This is called Poster 7, hanging right here on the wall. And it's vague, but this is essentially what these stormtroopers operate under.
Well, Poster 7 is not that hard to understand. Yes, it does say that you can take photos in auditoriums, lobbies, corridors, and foyers and lobbies during public meetings. But it also says you need the express written permission of the installation head or postmaster. Impact Media and Lizard Media, who were both there that day recording, have hid the videos. Now, I know a lot of you are thinking, oh, well, maybe they just had them taken down or their cameras taken. No, because they released a counter video to this news broadcast where they tried to make it look like they were the victims. Now, enough of these idiots. Let's take a look at a group of frauditors going to Philadelphia's Department of Health and Human Resources 2, startup drama and get kicked out.
Watch wallet, keys, and change.
Wallet, keys.
Everything has to come in your pocket. Watch wallet, keys, and change. Everything's in your pocket has to come out, please.
Any more?
Yes, it should be right here.
Now we have a who's who of dirtbag frauditors in this video. We have San Juan King Valley Transparency. We also have Wright's Crispy. We have Rogue Nation, Nate Skate 182, and a unknown female frauditor who's with them. They are in Philadelphia trying to get a FOIA request from the Department of Health and Human Services. But due to the pandemic, the Health and Human Services have set everything up for appointment only and have forms online where you can do FOIA requests. But that's not good enough for the frauditors.
Do y'all know? You can come closer if you want to. Talk about the background noise. Since COVID-19 and everything, lockdowns, everything, everything's done online by appointment-wise. So if you need to handle business with the city and everything.
So are you saying because of what happened, the people lost the Fourth Amendment right?
What the fuck are you talking about, man?
No, not at all. But they had a process and everything, trying to speed everything up. So if you need to, say,
But that's been already called off.
No. The lockdowns, yes, for nationwide and everything in the city. But how they process stuff, that's what they said.
But I mean, we don't have to wear masks. Right?
No, not that. No mask, no car stuff, none of that. It's all gone.
Do you see why the people were upset because of that? Because that
can't go on?
All of a sudden, that tries to overstep the boundaries of people's Fourth Amendment rights.
Yeah, I got
shenanigans. Shenanigans. And we're calling shenanigans, folks, because this is not a violation of the Fourth Amendment. The Fourth Amendment assures us protection from unlawful search and seizure. Just because the health department here and Health and Human Services have decided to have everything by appointment only doesn't mean it violates that. Not to mention that they have the 10th Amendment on their side, allowing them to set up their own rules and laws for the state. But why are frauditors from LA and Florida in Philadelphia in the first place? Now, these idiots have been all over PA and just getting into all kinds of shenanigans. I've seen them kicked out of other buildings, and now they're trying to pull their sticks here.
So we're gonna get records.
I'm allowed to make it by state law at the agency. I don't have to go
public
on the
record for what? Children? The thing is, you say public record, I got you.
Okay, so then, you also got me that I don't have to explain what it is to you because you're not the requester. You're not taking my request. My only obligation is to tell who I'm giving the request to what it's about. Please allow me to go in and make my request like state law allows.
I don't want any names. I don't want any faces. I want to know the count on deck.
I don't, but that's a public record that we can put in here.
And you're quelling us from going in there and getting the records.
Denying us.
You're denying us our records.
This is a problem.
And?
I'm trying to correct. We are entitled to that. That information is public. We're part of the public.
Call somebody from DHS. Let's get a supervisor down here, preferably somebody that knows state law.
In order to get through, do we have to be buzzed in? Yeah.
We're forced past trespassing.
You can't trespass a public building, though.
This is public air
right here. So, can someone come down and take my public records request?
What offices are in this building?
What offices are in
this building? Department of Human Services involving children and family.
That's it?
You notice it's on the same size on the other side?
Yeah.
It's all connected. Okay. Wait, if you have involvement in children.
You gotta know and understand that we do this all over the country.
That's
bro.
Fine, sir.
But this is why we do this.
I don't know if he's hearing me for reporting.
Yes, everyone's well aware that you go all over the country harassing people for no reason. You don't do this for transparency's sake. You don't do this for any legitimate news purposes. You do this because you've built an empire on harassing and annoying people to get content for a YouTube channel. And with the recent allegations of that San Joaquin Valley Transparency is taking over smaller channels and demanding they do things his way, or shutting it down and deleting their channels if they refuse, is questionable to his character and his sense of transparency.
If you involve your family, if you have family and kids involving in the state and everything, say family court.
What if we have general questions? General questions.
I have a general question, and it's...
As I said to him, same answer. It's not done here.
Yes, it is. It's a public record.
Yes, it is.
Public record.
I can ask for everybody's names and salaries.
This is an agency.
I can ask for everybody's names and salaries. I can ask for everybody who works here, get their names and salaries, find out where our taxpayer dollars are going. What I want to know is a simple question. What is the count on deck? How many kids and how many beds are in this facility?
Sorry, I don't do it.
I know you don't deal with that, but there is an agency who can give us that information. All they got to do is take down my email address and what I want.
Ooh. Just walk away when you're faced with facts. Common sense. Come on now. How do we know if a kid didn't get taken away by a fraud deputy? There was 130 kids here yesterday. Today's are 129. How do we know?
Now this is right Crispy's angle here. He wants to make everyone feel like the cops or the staff here are hiding something from the people. They're mistreating the children. Now we all know about the pasts of Right Crispy, San Joaquin Valley, and we all know how Rogue is. But what does this do to help the First Amendment? Because they were told no, they want to act like they're the victims. That their rights are being violated and they have no say in what they can do. They were told if they want to file Freedom of Information Request Acts, they can do it online. They can call and make an appointment to go to the floors they need to and go there. But because they were told no, it's everyone else that's hiding something other than
otherwise, no. So because I walked in with the camera in my hand, now I no longer have the Fourth Amendment nor First Amendment to go in there and ask questions and make records requests. Obviously, this guy doesn't know what he's
doing. That was a supervisor. Yeah, that's the supervisor. Yeah. For Scotland Yard security, so we're going to have to call and get his supervisor.
And
one man's Captain Johnson.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. That guy's already famous on our channel.
Got a little fuck.
It's been 5 years that he looks
silly. He makes up kind of funny faces.
Yesterday I was like, you still haven't learned?
And he stinks.
He makes faces and he stinks. His breath smells like hot garbage. I told the lady that the other day. Like, your breath's like fire. Hot garbage.
And we're going to end it here, folks. The video does continue on with them saying all kinds of derogatory things towards the security guard, that they're going to file complaints, that they're going to get him fired, the typical frauditor shtick, but end up leaving because they cannot go any further than the corner of that desk. So if you guys like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Leave a thumbs up and a comment because it helps with the algorithm. Don't forget to check out my second channel, NCR Movie Network, and my podcast, The Shit Towns, and Florida Man Power Ranking podcast with me and Anthony Caruso. With all that being said, be well, be safe, and I'll see you guys next time. And a special thank you to all members of the news team. Without your guys' continuous ongoing support, I couldn't keep the channel going. So I want to thank you all personally from the bottom of my heart.